my beautiful Leos, and welcome to your weekly love tarot reading for the week of January the 4th up until January the 11th. All right, let's jump right into your reading. Hello, hello, my beautiful Leos. How have you guys been? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and start calibrating to the energies of my wonderful Leos. Thank you so much, my guides, my angels, for providing any messages and guidance that my Leos are here seeking to find this week. What do we have for Leos this week? Always remember that energies are fluid, so take it as it resonates. If I'm not talking about you, it's a possibility that I'm picking up on the energies of the person that you are dealing with or the situation at hand. So always, always take it as it resonates. And remember that this can be for your sun, moon, rising, or your Venus placement. So if those are dominant within your chart, please make sure to check those out as well. And since it is a general reading, feel free to reverse the energies if you feel that they fit better that way. Okay, my beautiful Leos, you are starting this week with the dominant energy of the drum roll. Let's see what we have here. The Knight of Cups. Wow, look at that. An offer of love, a gesture, an apology, something or someone wanting to come your way to offer you the gift of love, the gift of an opportunity. Someone here is opening up their heart. They're opening up their emotions and they're opening up communications. If the lines of communication between you and this person, between you and the situation have been a little bit wobbly, have not been all that, you know, present, I feel here that this person wants to offer you their heart. Or there's this energy also where this could possibly be a brand new person, a brand new opportunity. It could be job related, it could be career related, or it can definitely, most of all, be love related. Okay, let's see what's going on here in your environment. Let's see what's going on. Okay, so we have here, wow, so some of you guys might be dealing with earth signs. I see any of the earth signs, any of the fire signs as well. Air signs are coming out across the board as well. What else do we have here? Water signs as well. Let's see right at the bottom. Okay, so I see the energy of Sagittarius as well. Wow, look at all of these beautiful future energies that you have here. Oh, wow. A future, a very bright future is opening up your way. Yeah, so someone here is dealing with either, it could possibly be a personality type that has not shown very much emotion. Perhaps at one point this person felt like a little bit closed off to you on an emotional level, but that's because this person had to emotionally withdraw their energy in order to regenerate or rejuvenate. It could possibly be you. It does not have to be another person, but I do feel here that there is a person here, okay, either you or them. Whoever did this, it wasn't because, it's sort of like maybe you took it personally, Leo, but it's not personal. It's just that this person had to back off. Perhaps they had a lot going on with work. Perhaps they just had a lot going on their plate. It seems that they needed to back off their energy because something was becoming a little too wild and out of control for them, okay? So I do feel here that this person is becoming a little bit bored, okay? Things are becoming a little bit monotonous for this person because I feel that one person is waiting, okay? There's one person here who is waiting for communication. They're like undecided. So this could possibly be you, my beautiful Leos, okay? If you're the one who has been a little bit undecided, I feel here that it's because you're kind of waiting for this person to make a move, but this person wants you to make a move. So you guys are kind of mirroring each other's waiting and anticipation energy, where both of you guys want exactly the same thing. Because look at this. This would not be here otherwise. This is an equal give and take. This is reciprocity. Look at this beautiful, gorgeous angel of temperance. You know, it's like tempering all of these emotions between both of you. See, all of these, both of these cups here represent emotions. So it's like there's this energy here where both of you guys want to kind of, there's this energy of reconciliation or maybe renegotiating or negotiating, okay? Does not have to be with a person from your past, but it could possibly be opening up to love, okay? So this could possibly be in the sense of your guides and your angels trying to make you understand that whatever it is that happened in the past is not a clear representation of what will come in your future, okay? So this is not about the person, whatever they did, but again, this is about the lesson. This is about calming the emotions and understanding a deeper meaning within everything that happened. So basically everything that happened, it was for this reason. It was for either for you to meet this brand new, gorgeous, handsome, or beautiful beautiful person. Okay, it could be male or female, does not matter. But this has to do with you opening up your heart again, okay? So if you have been a little bit closed off emotionally, God, source energy, your guides, your angels are telling you, go for it, go for it. Yes, faster, faster, okay? So this is sort of like the energy of, yes, embracing that energy of the universe working in your favor, okay? So it's like, there's this energy where some of you guys are waiting to see a nod from the universe, but guess what? The universe is waiting to see a nod from you to say, yes, universe, bring that manifestation into my life. Yes, I am ready to open up my heart, okay? So remember, real happiness is in your life. It is coming your way, but it's just a matter of you taking off that blindfold. See how this woman is blindfolded and is holding two swords? She's holding basically the answer to her prayers. She's like there, sitting there praying to God, God, can you please, you know, take off this blindfold or take off this burden from my life? Well, guess what? God is telling you, honey, you have the answer. Take one of these swords representing truth, okay? Representing truth, representing vitality, representing a brand new beginning. Cut off that blindfold and guess what? You are free. You are free to love. You are free to be loved. You are free to care for someone. You are free to be cared for by someone, okay? But let's go ahead and jump into your clarifiers. Let's see what this Knight of Cups is all about. What is this Knight of Cups here? What is this Knight of Cups? Oh, wow. Those two wanted to flip out. Oh, wow. Okay, so all three flipped out. Okay, we'll take them. We will take these. All right. So let's see what we have here. We have here the Five of Cups. Yeah, see, oh my God, there's one person here just waiting, waiting and watching, waiting for this person to come your way, waiting for your manifestation to come into fruition. And the universe is telling you, my dear, you need to take off that blindfold. It's right in front of you. It's here. So it's like, it looks like somebody's anxiety. It could be your anxiety or their anxiety, whoever this person represents. It could possibly be your person who has been very, very anxious. They don't know what to say, but there's one person here who has been experiencing a lot of anxiety, even though they're not showing it, okay? So remember, owning up to your own shadow, your truth of your desires is what's going to release you. This is what's going to unfold in the most beautiful of ways, okay? So there's one person here whose heart is just telling them, just do it, just go for it, okay? Or it could possibly be that you have been kind of like just quarantining at home. You haven't been really doing much, but the universe is telling you, Leos, get yourself out there, put yourself out there, go out on the dating scene, socialize with people. I know that it's not the best of times right now to do that, but at least just online, it could possibly be on a social media platform or just kind of like posting a picture of yourself, maybe your renewed self, perhaps a picture of yourself on your social media if you haven't been posting lately. But this is all happening for you, okay? Here we have the Hierophant in the reverse as well. Yeah, so you need to tune in and tap into your spirituality. You have the power within yourself to be your own leader, to be your own protector. And by default, you will attract people in that same vibration. So don't give up on love, my beautiful Leos. Remember, love is not the one that hurt you. It was the person who brought you the lessons, who broke your heart open so that you can know and recognize what true love is really about. And look what we have here. Here we have the Eight of Pentacles. The Eight of Pentacles means that if you want to create your own reality, then guess what? You're going to have to put in a little bit of effort, and a little bit of effort is exactly that. Perhaps what you've been doing over and over is not giving you a good result because you have to try something different. This is asking of you to try something different. Don't be too practical about things. I do feel here that someone new is going to come your way, okay? There's somebody here who has a lot of love for you, but right now you're not seeing it because you're so caught up in something from the past or something. It's kind of like being so worried that this is going to end up the way that it ended up the last time that you pay no attention to the opportunity, to the manifestation that is looking at you directly, okay? So here we have, you know, these energies here are just telling you, open up to love, open up to brand new opportunities or brand new job opportunities. It could possibly be that, okay? If you're looking for financial stability, for financial abundance, open up to new opportunities. They are here. They are being presented to you, okay? But here with this Five of Cups, somebody here does not feel that energy of vitality. Someone here has to get back in tune, in touch with the energies of you being the leader, of you recognizing your own magnetic power. power, recognizing that you are electrifying. Once you tap into that energy, your intent will be your reality. Your power of attraction is undeniable, but somebody here does not see it, okay? Whether this is you or them. All right, let's go ahead and see what my guides and angels have for my beautiful Leos. What do my guides and angels have for my beautiful Leos this week? What do my guides and angels have for my beautiful Leos this week? Let's see what we have here. Listen. Yeah, so let me read this one out. Quiet your mind, beloved one, and listen to our gentle reassurance that everything has been taken care of. So stay in a quiet and receptive state without worrying about the exact nature of your desires' manifestations. A quiet mind and body hears us quickly and clearly. This is our request to you to listen. So listen. Remember, somebody is calling your name. Somebody is here offering you this opportunity, but it's about time for you to listen. Don't listen to your anxiety or your fears. Listen to the voices of your guides and your angels talking directly to you. Okay, let's go ahead and get one more for my beautiful Leos. One more guidance and angel message. What do we have for Leos this week? Creative writing. So some of you guys, this is just confirmation that creative writing is an opportunity for you to advance in your career, or for others of you that are going through healing, this is a beautiful, beautiful way to heal in the form of journaling. So creative writing, you know, pour out all of the negative energy. Perhaps, you know, this is a brand new year, so open up a brand new notebook, buy a brand new notebook that inspires you, that moves you, that makes you feel good when you look at it, and write out all of your manifestations that you want to achieve for this brand new year, 2021. All right, my beautiful Leos, this is what I have for you this week. Thank you so much for watching. If you are interested in a personal reading, please do check the description box below, as I now have openings. And once again, happy, happy new year 2021. Let's all make it all the best. And follow my new Instagram page at Gina G Official, as I will be posting more on there. But I do hope that you enjoyed your reading. I do hope that it resonated. Let me know in the comments below if it did. And let me know what's going on. I really love reading all of your stories. Believe me, I read every single one of your messages. Thank you so much for sharing that in your comments below. If you did enjoy this reading, please do give it a thumbs up. It really helps to support me and my channel. And if you have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe to my channel. It really helps for me to continue posting these readings for you guys on this platform. Without further ado, thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.